Hey, I'm Paul Browning. I'm the author of IP Subnetting, Zero to Guru. Do you know, I used to suck at subnetting. I took my Cisco CCNA exam back in 2000 and subnetting just kicked my butt. I had about 7 IP subnetting questions, failed all of them, ran out of time and lost about $200. So I ended up writing IP Subnetting, Zero to Guru. So the problem with subnetting is you've got it in IT exams and you've also got it in technical interviews. So you need a fast method. Now, if you go online, I just search for Learn IP Subnetting or Subnetting Method, this simple 6-step subnetting method. Don't know the author. So we're going to follow this method and try and answer just a simple subnetting question that you would get in an IT exam. So let's go. Which subnet is host 192.168.100.100/26 in? So let's use this simple 6-step method. And bear in mind, in the exams and technical interviews, you've got 60 seconds. Subtract the prefix number from 32. So for example, if it's /29, take 29 away from 32. Okay, let's do this.
Let's take 26 away from 32. So 32, 26, that gives us 6. Okay, so we've got the number 6. Let's go back to our simple 6-step subnetting method. Calculate the subnet mask, convert the remaining bits to binary and sum them up. Okay, we're running out of time here, so let's convert them to binary anyway. So we need to convert 6 to binary now, and I don't know why. So 1, 2, 4, 8, 16. Let's work out, we use a 2, we'll use a 1, and we don't need a 0. So 1, 1, 0 is our binary version of what's left. Calculate the subnet size. Use the formula 2 to the power of n, where n is the number of host bits to find. We're out of time.
We failed the exam. So I'm going to show you a super simple method. All you need to do is write the subnetting cheat chart. You're allowed to use a board in your exams. Eventually, after a while, you'll be able to do it in your head. So let's go ahead to the easy method. So when you're in an IT exam, you're given a little whiteboard. I'll just hold up a piece of paper here, but it's a dry whiteboard, little tissue and a pen. So this is all you need to write down the subnetting cheat chart. I'll give you an example of what you'd write in the exam. Super quick, you only need to write this once and you can use it over and over again. So you basically will have a piece of paper and you'll draw a square and you'll just do something like this, and then you'll have lines going down here, so you'll hopefully have a straighter hand than me. What I'm going to do is hop over to the next slide, and this is a neater version. So basically, for now, just ignore what's going on down here. It doesn't matter, that's for something later on. So you've got some lines, horizontal and vertical. In the top, you will write this once. This is your binary math. Start off with the number 1 and double it. 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 1, 2, 8. And again, you only have to do this once for your entire exam. So you don't need to do binary with my method. You just need to write these numbers down. And then your possible subnets. You start off at the first number here, 1, 2, 8. These are your possible subnet values. Add 64. 192, add 32 to that, 224, add 16 to that, 240, add 8 to that, 248, add 4 to that, 252, and then add 2 to that, 254, and add 1 to that, 255. Okay, so basically you've got this chart. Now the clock would start, you're starting the exam, and you can answer your first question. So this is how to use the chart. Which subnet is host 192.168.100.100? So this is a traditional Class C address. If you've read anything, ignore all of this, we don't care. We're trying to find which subnet is host 100 in, and it's /26. So normally it's /24 for a Class C address. It's /26, so we've basically stolen 2 bits. Tick across here 2 bits, and our subnets go up in increments of 64. So let's use our 64 increment to count up and find out which subnet host 100 is in. We start off with the 0 subnet, 64, we add 64 to that to get 128, we add 64 to that, we get 192. There are our subnet values. Zero is no good because it's too low. 128 and 192 are too high. So host number 100 is somewhere in the 64 subnet. The answer in the exam you would tick is 192.168.100.64. And then you move on to the next question. Okay, next question. I'm not teaching subnetting. I'm teaching you how to answer questions in the exam, which is why I'm not explaining binary math. I'm not explaining classes A, B, and C. You kind of would read that in your theory. You just need the fast method for the exams. Which subnet is host 200.168.200.207/27 in? So I've written out the chart in full here. So this is what you'd be using in the exam. This is a class C address, not that it matters. We're subnetting in the last octet. Forget this, forget this, forget this. We need to find out where host number 207 is, and it's /27. So we've taken 3 bits. It would normally be 24. To get to 27, as I said, we've stolen 3 bits. Tick 1, tick 2, tick 3. You don't even need to worry about this part unless you want to write out the subnet in full. Our subnets are going up in increments of 32, and we can start off at 0. So 0, 32, 64. Why did I choose this? 96, 128, 160, 192, 224. All right, so we got the answer. Host 207 is in the 192 subnet. So the answer is 200.168.200.192. Move on to the next question. So the other question you get asked in the exams and technical interviews is network design questions. Which subnet mask will give me 16 subnets and 14 hosts per subnet? So this time, this is design. This is the design section. So all we need to do in the subnets column and the host column is just do 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, and you can keep going down. 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. All right, so say you click on next, this question comes up. You want 16 subnets. Tick until you get to 16 subnets. So 1, 2, 3, 4. You've ticked down 4 places. This is a class C. The last octet has got every octet has got 8 bits in. We've taken 4 bits for subnets. That leaves us 4 bits for hosts. 1, 2, 3, 4. We have to take away 2 in the host column, 1 for the subnet number and 1 for the broadcast. So that's 16 subnets and it's 14 because we have to take 2 away. What subnet mask? Sorry, we have to use this bit. 128.192.224.240. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4 bits down. So we've stolen 4 bits from here and we take 4 bits from here. So the mask is /28 because we've stolen 4 bits, or if you want to write it out, 255.255.255.240. And that's it. So there's a free course on YouTube. I'll put the link in the description. I'll put the link for IP Subnetting Zero to Guru. Good luck in the exams. All you need to do is practice now.